Will PRP ACell benefit my receding hairline since the hair follicles have only been dormant for about a year? I've been suffering from male pattern baldness for a little over a year. I've been using minoxidil, and my hair is almost completely restored, with the exception of my hairline. Will PRP ACell benefit my receding hairline since the hair follicles have only been dormant for about a year?
Thank you for your question. You stated in your question that you have a receding hairline and that you've been using minoxidil, which has had some benefit for you. And you're asking if PRP and ACell can help your receding hairline, since in your perception, the hairs have only been dormant for about 1 year. Well, I can certainly give you some guidance on this question. As a little bit of background, I'm a board-certified cosmetic surgeon and fellowship-trained oculofacial plastic surgeon. I've been in practice in Manhattan and Long Island for over 20 years. Hair transplant and non-surgical hair loss treatment has been a significant part of my practice. In fact, I'm the founder of TrichoStem Hair Regeneration Centers and have developed a system for treating hair loss non-surgically. We refer to as hair regeneration, and this does involve the use of PRP and acellular matrix. So, to give you perspective about your process and our experience, and we treat patients with hair loss, both men and women, with a 99% success rate for pattern loss for people who come to us from all over the world, and we have many years of data, which is the basis for our approach to this treatment. I think you're on the right track in that you're aware that the longer a hair is gone, the less likely that it's salvageable. Physiologically, hair thinning and hair loss can occur in basically one of two ways, just through observation. One is progressive thinning, which means the hair grows, sheds, comes back later, and comes back thinner, then sheds, and then comes back thinning. That's why it's called a thinning process. But there's other variations that we see where the hair grows, sheds, and just never comes back. So you're probably on the right track if you've observed thinning, that there are probably a lot of hairs that are not necessarily dormant, but rather they're just not growing the way they used to. What happens with hair loss? If we think about the physiology of hair, and it's kind of straightforward, there are three phases. One is called anagen, which is the active growing phase. The second one is catagen, which is a transition phase. And then there's telogen, which is a resting phase. What happens with pattern loss, male and female, is that the anagen phase gets shorter, the telogen phase gets longer, and it's certainly acceptable to refer to it as dormant, but rather it's just not regrowing. And if it is going to regrow, it'll grow back thinner. With hair regeneration, we have learned over the many years of doing this is that the earlier we catch someone, or the more follicles we can actually treat, the better it is. If someone comes to us who's bald, it's already too late. They don't have viable hair follicles. But if someone comes to us with any hair, then we can make a real impact. This has led to an advocacy to advise patients to continue to monitor and to look, or prospective patients, I should say, to come when you notice hair loss. You know, the earlier we treat someone, the better it is. We've learned from treating people who are middle-aged and older to then now middle-aged and considerably younger groups of patients. In fact, our youngest patient we've treated for male pattern hair loss was 17, 18 years old male, and even women are starting to come in who are in their 20s, and with biopsy, we've been able to establish them having androgenetic alopecia or pattern hair loss. So the earlier we can treat someone, the better it is. So I think that the answer to your question is that it is highly likely that you will see benefit in the frontotemporal area where you're seeing recession. The longer you wait, the less hair there is to work with. And I think that you can also look for a solution where there is monitoring. One of the things that I've observed for patients who come to us who have been on, let's say, minoxidil, they've been on minoxidil for 20, 25 years, and yet they continuously went on to lose all their hair. From my perspective, a drug like minoxidil has value in that it does prolong the growth cycle of thinning hairs and have some degree of a stimulatory effect on hairs that are not actively growing. But it does not stop the progression. With hair regeneration, we've been able to prove successfully with consistency. We're able to stop progression, in other words, stop the progressive process of hair loss. We're able to restore or reactivate hair that hasn't been growing, and any hair that is thinning, that after it sheds, will grow in thicker. So you can imagine that we've been very successful with this, and it has essentially displaced hair transplant for many potential people who come to us considering hair transplant. The more hair you have to start with, the better it is. That's the bottom line. So look for a specialist who can offer this type of solution. Learn about the option. Learn about their experience. I think that one of the challenges of developing this system was that we had to figure out a lot of different variables that contributed to the best outcome based on gender, age of onset, relative progression, relative severity, and other variables that I use in my process. And ultimately, we now are able to customize to individuals to help them get the maximum benefit. So I hope that was helpful. I wish you the best of luck. And thank you for your question.